Hey, hi guys, this is Baka Pajanjolikar. In today's Selenium tutorial, we'll discuss how to develop Selenium Cucumber BTD framework. Let us jump to the high-level agenda. First, we'll create a sample Maven project. Then we'll customize Maven project. Then after that, we'll be discussing how to create future file, step definition file, and test runner class. So finally, we'll be creating one utility method so that reads the properties file like URL and all, file path and all. So we'll be discussing what is the scenario we will be using to automate the web application. Then I will show you a sample demo. So when we create a first Maven project, the structure of the Maven project will be looking like this. It will be having SRC main Java, SRC main resources, SRC test Java, SRC test resources, and other folders like SRC target and pom.xml file. So when we customize this particular project, so it will be looking like this. So first we'll be deleting all the folders like all source and the test resources and Java resources folders. We'll be creating a fresh SRC folder. Under that, all the packages like step def, separate package where all the step definition contains. And one more package we'll be creating, test runner. Under that, our where exactly we'll be specifying the features to run. And we'll be creating one utility class that is a properties file reader under the utility package. Then we'll be creating one future folder. Under that, all the features will be there. Then we'll be creating one resource. Under that, I have created one browser config.properties that contains the browser URL. You can mention file path and sheet name and all. So this is the target. Under target, you can see the index.html. That is a report generated when we are executed this particular test runner class. So finally, we'll be creating one testng.xml file. We'll be executing testng.xml file. We'll be treating testng.xml file as a suit file. So let us jump to the Eclipse IDE and quickly create on sample Maven project, and we'll customize the Maven project. So here I'm clicking on the file. I'm going to new, then other. Here I'm searching for the Maven folder. So if you look at here, under Maven folder, you'll be seeing one Maven project option. Just say next and select this particular checkbox. Click on next button. Here you can give the group ID. So in my case, what I'm giving is com dot test automation. So next artifact ID is nothing but in similar way how you have provided a group ID, you can provide the artifact ID. So this artifact ID is nothing but your project name. So here what I'm mentioning is, here I'm mentioning Selenium Cucumber BDD framework. So that's it. So you can specify the name of the project and description for this. So what I will do is just I will copy this and I'll paste it in name and description. So I'm clicking on finish button. So if you look at here, so this is the same structure what we have seen in the our slides in the beginning of this tutorial. So what I will do is I'm going to delete all these all the 4 or 5 folders. So what I'll do is just I'm creating the one SRC folder. Right click on the project, go to the new, here save folder. Let us say, just click on cancel here. Right click on the project, go to the new. So here I'm creating the source folder. That's the reason here I'm selecting the source folder. I'm giving the name of the source folder as src. Click on finish. In the similar way, under source, I'm creating three packages. First one is com.testautomation.stepdev. That's it. I'll create another two packages, one for test runner, one for the utility method. So simply I'm deleting this one. So click on the SRC and create two another two packages. Here I'm saying com.testautomation. I'll say test runner. And click on finish button. In the similar way, I will create one more package. Here I'm just saying the package name as com.testautomation.utility. Click on finish button. So under this, I will create one class in each of the packages. In the first package stepdev, I'll create one class called you just specify the class name. So in my case, I'm specifying YouTube search stepdev. So click on finish button. Under test runner, I'm creating one class called test runner. Click on finish button. Under utility, I'm creating one more class called properties file reader. So that's all. Click on finish button. So SRC part is done. We need to create another two folders. One is future folder, another is resource folder. Let us create those two folders. Right click on the project, go to the, now you select the folder. So here you mention the futures . So in the similar way, I will create one more folder called resources. So that's it. Click on finish button. Under resources, I'll specify the future file. Right click on the future. Create one file. You need to select here it as a file. So here you mention the future file name. YouTube search dot future. So all future file contains the dot future format. So click on finish button. Why I have specified the YouTube search stepdev is we are going to automate the YouTube website. So that's the reason even I have specified the name of this particular future file as YouTube search.future. So once we create the folder structure, we will discuss the scenario, then we will start writing our code. I think it is got stuck. Just give me a second. So let me try to close this. Yeah, it is got created, YouTube search dot future. Under resources, I'm creating one dot properties file where I'm mentioning my YouTube URLs. So here I'm again going to the file because I wanted to create dot properties file. So here I'm mentioning browser hyphen config dot properties. Click on finish button. So that's it. So let us jump to the automation scenario which we are going to write our code. So first I will open this particular browser, Chrome browser, and I will type youtube.com. Then I will search here, like I'll search Selenium by Backup Iron. So this is my once we enter this particular search criteria, I will be clicking on this particular button. So this is my scenario. So let us jump to the Eclipse IDE here. So first what I will do is I will open this particular pom.xml file. Here you'll be in WoWview tab. Click on the pom.xml. So here you'll be seeing all this information, what we have provided, artifact ID and group ID and all. So this is the project name and this is our description. This all information we have provided when we are creating the project. So that's it. So here you need to mention the couple of dependencies and plugins. So that I have in the in text file. So here I'm just copying this all the plugins and dependencies. I will explain you what are the jar files I have mentioned and which version of jar files I have mentioned. That's it. So if you look at here, I have mentioned the one property. Then I have mentioned one Maven Surfire plugin. That is a version of 2.19.1. Then I have mentioned the java.exe file, where exactly in my system located. That is for Maven compilation purpose. Then I have mentioned one more Maven Cucumber reporting version of 3.15.0. This all reporting part. So coming to the dependency part, so I have mentioned the Selenium Java version of 3.11.0 and I have mentioned the TestNG with the version of 8. Then I have mentioned Cucumber TestNG version of 1.2.5. So that's it. So we need to close this particular dependency tag. So there's a reason in the line number 75 we are getting the error. Just I have saved it, so it will go this particular error because it is building it. Once building is done, it is that particular error will be going out. That's all. Don't worry about this particular pom.xml, this all properties and the plugins what I have mentioned. Just you can comment your email ID in the comment section of this below video. I will share this pom.xml file with you. So that will be easy for you to execute the scripts also. And also you can send out an email so that I can share the pom.xml file. So in pom.xml part is done. We have mentioned the all the plugins and the dependencies, whatever required to execute our Maven test. So I will go to the resources. We have created browser-config.properties. What I will do is here I will mention this particular YouTube URL. I mean youtube.com, I will be mentioning it here. I'll copy this particular URL and here I will say browser.base URL. So just I will assign this particular value to this particular browser.base URL. So I'll be using this particular key to access this particular URL. So another few minutes I'll be discussing how you can read this particular value by using this particular key. So that's it. So let us move on to the futures file. Just I'm opening this future file. So I have already created the future. So if you just, I'll copy this and I'll explain you what exactly each of the lines are. It is very simple. If you look at here, so by using the @, I'm identifying this particular future. So here I'm given the UAT testing as the representation for this particular YouTube search validations. Then I have scenario name. This you can mention the future, what exactly that particular model is doing and all. This is a scenario like I have mentioned YouTube search positive scenario. So this is all like with respect to the kind of scenarios you are writing. So these two are the one is future keyword we have used and one more is scenario keyword we have used. Then I have used given, then, sorry, when and then. So these are the Gherkin's keywords. This is all the already this is this particular keywords are implemented in the Cucumber framework. Cucumber and Gherkin's jar file. So in the first step, what I'm doing is, this is a very simple English. I have written, open Chrome browser and enter the URL. So in this particular step, what I'll be doing is, I'll be opening my Chrome browser and I'll be entering my URL. And the second step, by using the when keyword, I'm entering the search criteria. Enter search criteria. So that is this particular search criteria. After opening this particular Chrome browser, I'm entering this particular search criteria. Then click on search button. So that's it. Very simple scenario I have taken here. In the first step, I'm opening the Chrome browser and entering the URL. In the second step, in when, I'm entering the search criteria. And then I'm clicking on the search button. So that's it. Let us move on to the test runner. What I'm doing is here, I'll go to my text file. I'll copy this entire lines. And I'll paste it here. Don't worry, I will explain each and every lines, what exactly each of the lines are doing. So once you written this particular code, just import the related packages. So I will explain you one by one each lines. Just give me a second, I will import all the related packages. So that this particular annotation test comes from the TestNG annotation. Even data provider also comes from the TestNG annotation. So this particular Cucumber future wrapper also comes from Cucumber API TestNG. So finally you import this particular after class from test engine annotation. So that's it. So let me explain you what exactly this particular Cucumber option contains annotation. So this is a future file where exactly my futures are located. If you look at here, I have specified the ./futures. So here I have specified YouTube search .future that comes under the futures directory, right? So that's the reason I have specified the futures location, and the glue is contains the step def, where exactly my step definition contains for this all the steps. So they should be implemented somewhere in the in my framework, right? So that's the reason these step implementations are done in the this particular class. So that's it. So that we can do it a little later. So once I explain this particular class, so I'll be implementing the YouTube search criteria, sorry, YouTube search step def Java file. Then we'll be writing one utility method that reads the test data, I mean the URL from this particular resources. So this glue contains the where exactly my step definitions contains. Tags is nothing but I have given here annotation UAT testing. So this is the name I have provided in the this particular futures file. If you look at here, so I have represented this particular future as a @UAT testing. Then this part is plugin is equal to, this part is for generating our index.html report. If you look at here, I have shown you the one slide. So this particular index.html report, if you write this particular line, these statements, it will generate you the this particular index.html report. So that's it. Let me maximize it. So next part is all the annotations, just it is a before class and annotation test and annotation data provider and annotation after class. So I will explain each of the test methods. If you are not that much clear about the test engine annotations, I highly recommend you to go to the YouTube. So here you just search by Selenium by Buckappa. So here, if you look at this particular playlist, Selenium quick video tutorials using real-time web applications, click on this particular playlist. Here there are many videos. Come to the video number 32. If you look at here, introduction to test engine framework annotation, and part 2, part 3, part 4 and so on. So these all are very basic for the test engine annotations and test engine framework. So I recommend you to watch these videos, so it will be easy for understanding whatever we have written in this particular test runner class. So let me explain you what each of the methods are doing here. This annotation before class, if this particular test method will be getting executed before running any of the test methods in this particular class. So what it is doing is simply it is pointing to the this dot get class. So it is getting this particular class and all these properties. So once it is got all the properties, so it is executing the annotation test. This particular annotation test is getting the one parameter called data provided is equal to futures. This particular futures method is implemented here only. So this is the name we have given in the data provider is equal to futures. So what exactly this data provider does is, this particular data provider, it gets all the future from this particular location with this tags. One by one, it will process to this particular annotation test. So that time, this particular test will be get executed first time. If we have mentioned multiple tags, so multiple futures will be coming from this particular location and it will be executed from the annotation test method. So in this particular after test, after class, just it will close this testng cucumber runner connections, all the, so which is opened by before class. In this particular method, this particular connections will be opened with the testng cucumber runner, that is the inbuilt class. Testng cucumber runner is the inbuilt class, so just we are, by using that reference variable, we are just getting the class and the all the features, then finally we are closing connection to the testng cucumber runner dot finish. By using the finish method, we are just closing all the connection to the testng cucumber runner. So that's it. So let us create a testng class for this test runner. Right click on the test runner, here select the option as testng. Here you say convert to testng. So this is where exactly your testng.xml will be getting generated. So your suit name is suit and test is test. You can, if you want to, just you modify this to parameters, and wherever you want, you can create a folder and you can keep it this particular testng.xml file. So in my case, let it be like this. So I'm clicking on the finish button. If you look at here, this particular testng file got generated. So if I go to the source tab, so this is a simply, it has pasted the this testng runner dot java is there, right? That particular class fully qualified name is mentioned in this class name. So overview for this particular testng.xml file is, so one is suit tag, you can mention the suit name, and test, you can mention the thread count. At a time it can run 5 tests at a time. Under the classes, we have mentioned the class which we want to run, where we have specified our test runner class. So if I right click on this particular testng class, just run it, run as testng suit. So let us cancel it, just save it, all the files. Now you can execute this particular testng.xml file as a testng suit. If you go here, so it is saying configuration failures. So how it can be done is, so still you have not developed any YouTube search criteria, search step def and the properties file still. So what I will do is, I'll go to this particular step def package class. Here I'll specify the all the steps definition for the each of the futures in this particular future file. So we have total three steps. For each of the three steps, I have a step definition methods. So I'm going to this particular class. So what I will do is, I'll copy this entire lines. So I will explain you what each of the lines are doing here. Let me maximize it. So here, this is annotation given is nothing but, let me close others. So I'll open the future file. So annotation given is nothing but this particular first step. So if you see this particular description, open Chrome browser and enter URL. Here you can see that open Chrome browser and enter URL. In the same way, second step we have enter search criteria, and that is in when keyword, right? So in the when keyword, you can see enter search criteria. So in the third step, click on search button. We have a click on search button. So that is contains the annotation then. So what I will do is just I will import all the annotation given. Let me import related packages, but yeah, still I'm not getting this particular packages. So what I will do is I will right click on this particular project and I will say Maven update project. Click on OK button. That's it. So now try if we are getting or not. Still we are not getting any of the annotations to import. Let me close that particular feature file. So what I will do is I'll open this particular pom.xml and I'll check what if some errors are there in this particular fix pom.xml. So there are no errors, no wrong with this pom.xml. Let me close this. Let us try now. Now it is not working still. So what I will do is I will right click on this particular project and I will say run. Clean this particular Maven. I will say Maven clean. So it will clean the Maven project. So that's it. And I'll say update Maven project. So that's all. So I think we have some issues here. Okay. Just give me a second. I will look into the issue. What exactly the problem is here? I'm getting Chrome driver, but I'm getting these properties. Let me import the packages and we'll see why we are not getting the for importing annotation given and annotation when. So this is the object what we have created for the reading properties file. So we can implement this particular class, no issues. Let me import manually and we'll check. Just give me a minute, I will check out. Let me check if we are missing some pom.xml dependency. That's correct. If we look at here, we have missed some dependencies. So I will copy this dependency and I'll paste it there. So here, what you need to do is, so we should be very careful in mentioning the dependencies especially. So if I do this, so I should be getting those options now for importing. So if you look at here, I'm getting the import given, and import when, and import then. So these all the features comes from the Cucumber BDD jar file. So that's it. So here it is very simple. Let me implement this particular class properties file reader. So what I will do is I'll go to this particular utility, that is we have given the properties file reader class here. So I will take the code from this particular, not from the form. So I'll copy this particular method. And I'll paste it. So I will explain you what exactly each of the lines are doing here. Just import all the packages, that's all. So here I have implemented one method called getProperty method. So it returns me this particular data from the properties file. So in our case, I have specified only single browser-config.properties. So we have mentioned only one value, that is browser.baseURL. So how you can use this particular key and how you can get this particular value. So this is where we have a properties file reader class. So I have written here the get property method. So return type of this particular method is properties type. So whenever you call to this particular method, so you need to store the value in terms of properties only. So in the first, just I have specified the file input class and I have assigned the null value. Then I have created the object of properties class. By using the object of this properties, I'm loading this particular location file. If you look at this particular path of this particular under the file input stream, so that is under, if you look at this particular folder structure under resources, we have one file called browser-config.properties. So in the same way, this particular, where exactly this particular location of the browser-config.properties file I have mentioned. So this is the path where exactly my properties file is there. Then I surrounded this particular statement with the try and the catch block. If anything occurred in this particular, while loading this particular location file, so that will be catched by the catch statement here. Finally, after loading this particular file, so it will return in terms of properties. By using this object, you can access to that particular whatever you have mentioned under the URL and all. Just I'm closing this. I'm going to the stepdef file. So that's all. Just import the related packages here. So this is the object I have created for the this particular class. So if you look at here, just we have implemented this particular class, right, with the get property method. So I have created the object for that properties file reader. That's it. Then I have defined the one static web driver. So by using this driver object, I'm going to find the web elements. In the first step, what I have done is, it is very straightforward. By using the properties, if you look at this properties file reader object, by using this object, I'm getting the property, get property. So I call to the get property method. So after that, I'm storing that into the properties tag. So where by using this properties reference variable, I can access anything specified in this particular browser hyphen config.properties file. So you'll see how we have accessed that particular youtube.com URL. So in the second step, it is very simple. We are launching the Chrome browser. This is where I have kept the my Chrome driver.exe. So after that, I'm launching the Chrome driver and we are maximizing it in this line. Then if you hear, we will be mentioning manually before in the Selenium tutorials. But now what I have did is, by using this properties object, I'm using get property method. And after that, I'm specifying this key value. If you look at here, we need to mention the proper key value here. I'll go to this particular properties file. I'll copy this particular key and I'll fetch this youtube.com as a URL. So I'll paste it here as a key. That's it. I will delete this line, not required. So this is a very first step what we have in the future file. In the second step, what I'm doing is, in the first step, just we are launching the browser and we are entering this URL. And after entering this particular URL, we need to enter this particular value into search box and we need to click on this particular button, right? So that's the reason I'm identifying this particular search element by using the ID. So if you look at here, ID is equal to search we have. So that's the reason I specified the ID here. Just import the by from the Selenium. So here I'm entering some value. So I'll say Selenium by Buckappayan. So by using Senkis, I'm sending the data in the second step. So first step, what it is doing, it is opening the Chrome browser and entering the URL. In the second step, we are doing enter search criteria. So I have identified this particular search text box and I'm sending this particular value to that field. Then in the third step, I'm clicking on the search button. So I have identified this particular button by using the CSS selector. If you copy this particular value, click on the HTML tags, press Ctrl F, then paste the value. So if you look at here, it is identifying that particular web element. So that's it. So what I have done is, just I have used the ID value. If you look at here, ID is equal to search icon legacy, right? So just before this particular value, I have used a hash symbol. That is nothing but our CSS selectors. So after that, we need to click on this particular button, right? So that's the reason we need to call to the click method. That's it. So our step definition file is ready. Let me close all the things. So we have created step def file, test runner package and utility method. In this YouTube search step def file, you have all the steps we implemented. That is, one is opening browser and entering the URL. In the second step, we are entering search criteria. In the third step, we are clicking on that particular search button. So that's it. The test runner we have specified where exactly my future file is there where exactly my step definition file contains. In the tags, we have specified where what is the future, what exactly we have represented that particular future by using the annotation at the rate, and this is for the HTML report format. And after that, we are using annotation before class and after class. In between, we are used annotation test and annotation data provider to get the all the futures. So that's it. From the properties file reader, just we are loading this particular file, where particular file, and we are returning the properties. By using this particular object, we are accessing that in the YouTube search step def file. That is, here we are accessing this particular URL in the step definition file. So that's it. And we have in the futures, we have specified the scenario. In the resources, we have specified the URL. So that's it. What I will do is I will right click on this particular testng.xml file. I'll say run as testng suite. We should be very careful in mentioning the pom.xml. So that's the reason we have faced little bit issue. So you can comment in the comment section so that I can share my pom.xml file. So that will be helping you a lot in executing Selenium BDD scripts. So if you look at here, only one test scenario, it is got passed. There are zero failures and zero skipped. And if you come to this particular target under this, just refresh one time this particular project. So if you come here under the site, under Cucumber Pretty, so here you'll be seeing the index.html. Double click on this index.html. Here you'll be seeing that particular future. What exactly that future contains, description, then the scenario name. Under that, we have only three steps specified, right? One is opening the browser and entering the URL and search criteria and clicking on the search button. So if you look at here, all the steps are got passed, and if something is got failed, here you'll be seeing the all the description. Let me show you the failed scenario. What I'll do is I'll go to step def file. Here I'll say, instead of identifying this particular CSS selector, I'll just modify. I'll specify the wrong CSS selector. So let us see how it will run. So it should throw us the error. So if I run this particular testng.xml file, so it should say no such element found exception and all. That should be printed in the index.html report. If I go here, it is saying no such element found exception, because it is not able to identify that particular search button with the selector value. If I go to this particular index.html, so all the exception information is printed over here. So whatever printed on the screen in the console, all the information you can see in the index.html report. So that's all I have in this Selenium Cucumber BDD framework development. If you have any questions, you can drop me an email to my Gmail ID. So next Selenium Cucumber BDD tutorial with page object model. Stay tuned for the next tutorial. Click on subscribe button to get more updates from this particular channel. Thank you so much for watching this Selenium Cucumber BTT tutorial. Yeah, hi guys, this is Bakkappa Chincholikar. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to develop hybrid automation framework, which is a combination of BDD, Cucumber BDD plus page object model, Selenium and TestNG. Let us jump to the high level agenda. So for this tutorial, there is a prerequisite that you need to go through with that particular Selenium tutorial. Then we'll discuss why we need a page object model. Then we'll discuss what is page object model. Then we'll discuss what is page factory. Then we will discuss advantages of POM. Then how to implement a page object model. Then we'll discuss a simple automation scenario. In the demo, we'll be implementing page object pages future file. For each of the future file, there will be a stub definition file. So then we'll be implementing the utility method. Let us jump to the prerequisite. So if we go to the YouTube, just search by Selenium plus Cucumber BDD plus TestNG customized framework development by Bakkappayan. So if you search this particular video, you can go through with very first video. Otherwise, what you can do is go to the youtube.com. Here search Selenium by Bakkappayan. So if you go to the Selenium quick tutorial playlist, this is the last video in my channel. So if you go to this particular, you will get an idea like how to develop, which is a combination of Selenium Cucumber BDD plus TestNG framework. So that's it. That is a prerequisite for this particular hybrid automation framework development. So in that particular video, what we have discussed is we have created a simple source folder. Under that, we have created a stub definition package. Under that, all the stub definition for the future files. In the test runner, we have mentioned where exactly our future file and where exactly our stub definition file, so that we can run a particular scenario or particular future file. So in the third utility, we have created a properties file reader. So that reads the properties from this particular resources folder. So in the resources folder, we have a browser-config properties. So we have mentioned the URL of that particular website, and we try to automate the application in the previous Selenium tutorial with the Cucumber BDD. Then we have created one sample future file folder. Under that, we have created one future file. So for each of the future file, there will be implementation class, that is a stub definition class. And we have discussed this particular index.html report after executing this test runner as the TestNG XML file. So let us jump to the why we need a page object model. So if you look at this particular snippet of code, first we are identifying that particular web element by using the XPath, that is having the value as a test one. We are sending the value as Selenium by Bakkappayan, and we are clicking on that particular button. The next time, what we are doing, we are identifying the same element by using the driver.findElement. So if you look at this particular XPath, it is having the same value as a test one. So we are passing the different value here, Selenium Cucumber BDD by Bakkappayan. The next time we are passing Selenium TestNG by Bakkappayan. Next time we are passing Selenium C# by Bakkappayan. The last time we have passed Selenium by Bakkappayan. So if you look at this driver.findElement, that is having the only single XPath, that is a test one value. So in the later point, if any changes made in the development side, in the HTML part, so it got changed. Just assume it got changed the XML, what we have, right? XPath, that is got changed. So you need to walk through into all these codes. Like if you have 100 scripts or 1000 scripts, you need to do walk through with each of the test scripts, and you need to update the particular web element value, that is the XPath. So to manage web elements as a global, so we have a concept called page object model. So let us go to the next slide. So what is page object model? Page object model is a design pattern to create an object repository for web-based applications. In this POM, POM is nothing but page object model. For each web page, there will be corresponding page class. So here I have taken the example of youtube.com. So when you go to the youtube.com, you'll be seeing a search page. That's the reason here I have created the YouTube search page. And once you are searching something in the search page, once you click on search button, so it is navigating into the next page called YouTube result page. Then if you click on any of the channel name, it is going to the channel name page. So that's how you are creating corresponding page class in the Java for each of the web pages. So each web page, all the elements of that particular page, and also page method which perform action on those web elements. Say for example, in the YouTube search page, you are entering the search criteria and you are clicking on that particular search button. So that particular action method or abstraction method will be implemented in the corresponding pages class, that is in YouTube search page. So name of the method should be given as per the task they are performing. So that will be very easy to identify the method, what exactly that particular is doing. That is the naming convention you have to use in your framework. So next slide we have, what is Page Factory? Page Factory is an inbuilt page object model concept for Selenium WebDriver. It is very optimized. Page Factory is an optimized way to create the object repository in POM concept. So next we have advantages. There are many advantages if you implement page object model concept with the Selenium Cucumber BDD framework. So operation and flows in the UI should be separated from the verification. So this concept makes our code cleaner and easy to understand. So whatever are performing your action on the UI, that will be implemented, that particular method will be implemented in a corresponding page class itself. So that particular action will be not implemented in a step definition file or a test cases. Second is object repository is independent of the test cases. So code becomes less and optimized because of the reusable page methods in the POM classes. So all action methods will be implemented in the corresponding page classes itself. So duplicate code can be avoided. Easy to maintain if you have a separate page object repository and your step definition file or test cases. Easy to maintain and reusability of the code will be more. So this is how you need to implement your page object model with the Selenium Cucumber BDD. So we follow the concept of separation of page object repository and a step definition. So we separate the page object repository and the step definition. Both the files will be created in a structured manner. We use annotation find by, to find web element by using the locators like ID, name, tag name, link text, etc. So init elements method is used to initialize all the web elements in that particular page class. So if you look at here how we can implement the page object model concept, first we are creating a page classes. So in that particular page, we will be implementing all our web page elements and action methods, which is going to perform action on that corresponding page. And if you look at a step def class, so just we are calling to those particular methods which are there in the page object classes. So let us jump to the scenario. So we are going to automate this particular scenario. Just I'm going to discuss it. After opening this particular browser, we are entering this youtube.com. We are entering something in the search text box. Here we are entering the Selenium by Buckapayan. Then click on this button. So we are getting the result page. So if you look at here, so this is our search page. If I click on search button, this is our result page. And if I click on this particular link, it is going to the page. So here what we need to do is, we need to validate this particular title of this particular page tab is displaying properly or not. That is the main thing we'll be achieving it after covering this entire tutorial by using the Selenium Cucumber BDD with the page object model. So let us go back. So here I'm typing youtube.com. So here we need to create three pages. First is search page. Second one is result page. The third one is channel page. So let us go to the Eclipse IDE and quickly we'll create three classes. So here I'm creating one package under the source com.testautomation.pageobjects. Here I'm giving the name of this particular package name as pageobjects. Click on finish. So let me rename this particular . So that's it. Let us create quickly three classes. So here I'm specifying the first class as YouTube search page. So that's it. So here I'm creating one more class called YouTube result page. So I'm creating one more class. Let me specific YouTube channel page. So that's it. We have created three pages. First one is YouTube search page, YouTube's results page, and YouTube channel page. Let us go to the YouTube search page. So in this particular page, what we need to do is, we need to enter the search criteria here and we need to click on this particular button. So I'll identify this particular button, text box. Here we have so many attributes. Here I'm using the ID for this particular web element to identify. So basically in the page object model, what we need to use is annotation find by. Under that, we need to specify how you are going to identify the particular web element. So here I'm specifying by using the ID. So here you'll be seeing all the locators, what we have in the Selenium. So here I'm specifying by using the ID. So this how returns the type of value is how type. Then you need to specify the value under the using keyword. So I'm specifying this particular ID, value, that is a search in the under the using statement. That's it. I need to rename this particular web element by using public. This is a web element, so that's the reason I'm writing web element here. So that is search text box. So that's it. Just import the related packages. So very simple. Next, I need to identify this search button. So if I inspect it, here I'm getting the button tag. Under that, I have ID is equal to so and so value. That is search icon legacy. So if I press Ctrl F, So here I'm identify this particular value by using the CSS selector. So just I will copy this entire web element, I will paste it. So here I'm identifying this particular search button by using the CSS selector. So that's the reason here I need to change the locator. So what I will do is I will write CSS. That's it. Here I need to specify the this particular value. So this is our search button, right? So I'm modifying this particular web element name as a button. So that's it, very simple. We have created two web elements. In this particular web page, that is YouTube search page, what we are doing is we are searching for the some videos on the YouTube. So that action method has to be implemented in this particular class only. So what I will do is here I'm implementing one method called public void navigate to result page. So once I click on this particular search button, so it is navigating into the result page. So that's the reason naming conventions are very important when you are writing your abstraction methods in the page classes. Here I'm specifying the navigate to result page as a method name. So that's it. So I need to use this particular search text box. I need to send the some value to that particular search text box. So what I'll do is here I'm entering selenium by backup ion. So that's it. I need to click on this particular element. So that's the reason I'm using search button. So I'm clicking on that particular web element. So that's it. To initialize all these web elements, we need to define one constructor. So whenever we create the object of this particular class, it initializes all the web element in this particular class. So that's the reason here I'm defining one constructor that accepts the argument as the web driver type. So public, here I need to specify the class name. So always constructor will be having a class name. Constructor name will be same as the class name. So this particular constructor accepts the type of argument is web driver type. Then we should define one own class web driver object. So that's the reason here I'm defining web driver object. So that's it. So I'll take this particular driver and I'll assign to the current class. So that's the reason here I'm using this keyword dot driver, and I'll assign this coming driver to the current class driver type. So that's it. To initialize all the web elements like search text box and search button, so we have one inbuilt method called page factory dot init elements. So this accepts the two arguments. First one is a driver which is coming from the different class, then it points to the own class by using this keyword I'm specifying it. So this it initializes all the web elements from the current class. So first class that is a YouTube search page is ready. So same way I will copy this constructor and find element lines to the next page, that is a YouTube search page. Once we are ready with the page object model concept, all the pages, then we will create suddenly one feature file. Then we'll create a step definition file for the feature file, and we'll start utilizing all these page object model concepts in the step definition file. So here I'm renaming this particular class name with the constructor name. So always constructor name should be same as the class name. So in the result page, we need to click on this particular channel name. So what I will do is I'll inspect this. So it is, if you take your mouse on the this particular channel name, it is looking like a link, right? So that's the reason I will identify this particular element by using the link text. So here what I will do is, here I'll specify as a link text, then I'll specify the value here. So that's it. In this page, we need to identify only single element, that is the channel name. Then we need to click on this particular element. For clicking on this particular element, we need to implement one behavioral method or an abstraction method. So that's the reason I'm implementing one simple method, so that clicks on the channel name. So public void navigate to channel. So that's it. So I will use this particular web element. I'll say just click on this particular web element. Just we have identified by using the link text. Before that, I will specify some weight, thread.sleep. So that's it. So our first page is ready, that is YouTube search page, and the second page is ready, that is a YouTube result page. And we need to implement one more page, that is called YouTube channel page. So from this page, what we need to do is, we are going to validate this particular title of this particular web page. We have title as this. Title is Selenium Java Test Engine Tutorials Buckeye and YouTube. So this particular title will be verifying. So let us go to this particular page. So this is not required. Let me delete. So that's it. So in this particular page, what I need is, I'm not going to perform any action on this particular page, but what I'll do is, I'll implement one simple method that returns the title of this particular tab in this page. So here I'm implementing one method, public return type should be string, and here I'm saying get title. So that's it. So as return type of this particular method is string type, so I'm mentioning the return. I'll use the driver object dot get title. So we have already one inbuilt method called get title, so that returns you the title of that particular web page. So that's it. So before that, I will use some weight thread dot sleep. So you can specify explicit weights, no issues. So that's it. So we are done with the page object model. That is, we have created three pages, that is YouTube search page, YouTube result page, YouTube channel page. So next part is, we need to create one simple future file. Let me create one simple future file here. So here I'm specifying the future file name as YouTube channel validation. Dot future. So click on this finish button. So let me open this particular channel, YouTube channel validation future file. So here I'm writing future keyword followed by the name of this particular feature. Here I'm specifying YouTube channel name validation. So that's it. After that, we need to specify the scenario, like there will be a plenty of scenario under this one single feature. So here I'm specifying the one simple scenario by using the scenario keyword. So just simply I will copy paste this particular description of the future description of the future. So that's it. Validations. So after that, what we need to do is we need to, by using the Gherkin keywords, we need to write the scenario for this particular automation scenario, what we have discussed and what we have implemented page object model concept. So let us implement from the beginning here. So first we need to open the Chrome browser and we need to enter the youtube.com. So it's the same way I will be implementing one step here by using the given. So given is a Gherkin keyword. So that's the very first step you need to mention. Open Chrome browser with URL. So that's it. The first step is ready. Then the second step is, so here I'm specifying the when keyword. So after opening the browser and after entering the URL, so we need to enter the search criteria, right? After entering this particular search criteria, we need to click on this particular button. So that we have already implemented in the page objects. So in the steps I will be writing. So here, search Selenium tutorial. It is very common English. That is what we use in a daily basis. Search Selenium tutorial, then and after searching this this particular Selenium tutorial, we are clicking on this particular channel name. So that should be the next step. So here I'm telling and click on channel name. So that's it. Then we are validating this title of this particular web page. So here I'm specifying validate channel name. So our future file is ready. I'll represent this particular future with the annotation. So here I'm saying UAT testing 2. So copy this particular tag name. So I'll go to the test runner class here. As you know, in the future we are specifying where exactly our futures are exist. In the glue, we are specifying where exactly our step definition files are exist. So that we are going to implement in the few seconds. So here we need to specify exactly which future and which scenario you wanted to run it. So here I'm pasting this particular future file name, that is what we have implemented just now, this one. So I have specified here. So that's it. So I'm going to run this particular testng.xml file as a testng suite. So if I open this particular console, you can implement all the missing steps in the snippets below. So I will just copy this particular all the steps and we are going to implement all the steps in the step definition package. So here I'm creating one fresh class. That is Java class. So here I'm specifying the name of this particular class as YouTube channel validations. So that's it. So click on finish. So I'll open this, I'll maximize this and I'll paste all the copied it from the console one. So let me delete all these stuffs. So let us import all relevant packages here from. So this should be Cucumber API. So all these keywords coming from the Cucumber API. Make sure that if you are missing it from importing from a Cucumber API, you will get some exceptions. So our step definitions are ready. So we need to use the all existing methods which are there in the page objects. So what we need to do is, first we need to open the browser with URL. That is the very first step we need to implement. So that's the reason in the beginning of this particular Selenium Cucumber tutorial, I have told like we will be implementing one utility method for handling the browsers. So what I will do is, I will go to this particular utility package. I'm going to create one simple class. So that is called browser utility. So that simply takes the driver object and it takes the URL and the browser name. Based on those parameters, it is going to launch our browsers. So here I'm specifying the browser utility as the class name. So click on finish. That's it. If I go to this my text notepad, so I'll copy this. I'm going to explain you what exactly each of the lines are doing it here. It is very simple. Just it will accept the few parameters and it will return the browser based on that. So just import the related packages. So that's it. So if you look at this particular return type of this particular method as WebDriver type. So whenever you are calling to this particular method, you need to store that value into the WebDriver type. So you can use it in the future in the same step definition class. So this particular open browser method accepts the three arguments, that is the driver and the browser name and the URL. So based on that, if it is a Chrome browser, so it is going to launch me the Chrome browser. This is where exactly my Chrome browser exists in the location, that is driver.exe. Then it is going to launch me the Chrome browser and it is going to maximize the browser and it is going to enter this particular URL that is coming from this particular parameter. In the same way, it will check this particular browser name. If it is equal to this IE, so it is going to launch me the IE browser. In the same way, it will check this browser name parameter. It will check if it is a Firefox. If I pass the argument as a Firefox, it is going to launch me the Firefox browser and it is going to maximize it. And finally, it is going to return you the driver object. If none of the browsers are matching with the browser name, like Chrome or IE or Firefox, so it will return you the null value. If you have passed, say for example, it is accepting the Firefox as a parameter. If you mention F as a small case, it is not going to match with this particular line. So simply it will return you the null value from this particular method. So that's it. So let us go to the step definition class and we will call to this particular method which is there in the browser utility class. We are having method name as a open browser. So we need to pass three parameters. Before that, what I will do is, I will keep my this browser name and the URL in the properties file. We have discussed already how to read the properties file. We have already implemented one class called properties file reader. So this is going to return us the where exactly this particular file is there, and it loads all the properties and it will return you the properties by using the get property method. You can get the value of that particular properties file. So what I will do is, browser name and the URL, I will be mentioning it in the this under resources. I'll open this browser hyphen config properties. Already we have a URL mentioned. In the same way, I will mention the browser name. So here I'm specifying browser dot name. So this should be our, if you mention here as a Chrome, it is going to launch the Chrome browser. And if you mention here IE, so it is going to execute your scripts on the IE browsers. So that's it. This particular key will be using in the while calling in the methods. So that's it. Let's go to the step definition file. So if I come here, so I'm, as it is a browser utility having the static method open browser, I'm using this particular class name dot. I can call to this particular open browser by, because as it is a static method. So I'm going to the step definition class. Let me close all, cancel it. Let me save it, this one. Let me close all the windows. So I'm going to open the step definition file, that is a YouTube channel validation. So here I'm going to call that particular method. So in the first step, what we have is open Chrome browser with URL. So that accepts the browser and the URL, and it is going to return it to the browser. After launching that particular browser, it enters the URL and it will, it gives you the driver type. So that is what we have discussed in the this browser utility class. So what I will do is I will call to the open browser. So if you look at this particular method, so it is accepting you the driver object, that is fine. We need to mention the browser name and the browser URL. We have browser name and the browser URL in the properties file. That is where we have in the browser-config.properties. That is the browser name, browser URL and the browser name we have in the properties file. So how you can read the properties file, as we have discussed in the previous Selenium Cucumber tutorial. So if we go to the previous step definition, so we have created the object of this particular class and we are calling to this getProperty method, and it is returning you the type of value is properties type. By using this property here, if you look at here get method, I'm going to call one more method called getProperty. Under that, I'm simply specifying the key value. So in the same way, what I will do is I'll copy this particular line. I'll go to here, the step definition, I'll paste it here. In the same way, I'll copy this. Paste it here. So here what you can do is by using these properties. So in the high level, I can discuss what exactly this particular properties file reader is. So simply in the file input stream, we have assigned the null value. We have created the object of properties class. By using this properties object, I'm going to load this particular location file. This is where our properties, I mean the resources file is exist, that is browser-config properties file. So finally, it is returning the type of value is properties type. So that's the reason we are storing that into the type of value is properties type. So I'll use this properties object dot. This is an inbuilt method, getProperty. Here you need to specify the key. So if you look at here, it is asking me the value of, type of value is key type. So simply what I will do is in the double quotes, I'll go to this particular browser-config properties. I'll copy this particular key and I'll paste it here. In the same way, I'll copy this . So first we need to mention the Chrome browser name, I mean the browser name. So if you look at here, so it is asking me browser name. So here I need to specify the browser, browser name. So I'll go to this browser-config properties file. I'll copy this browser.name and I'll paste it here. That is the first parameter is driver. Then second parameter is browser name. That is coming from the browser-config properties. Then the second parameter is browser-base URL. So that's it. So in the current class, we need a driver because this particular method returns the type of value is driver type. So here I'm specifying private web driver. So that's it. Just import the related packages. So I'll copy this driver and I'll assign this particular open browser properties value to the driver type. So what happens in the first step? So it opens the Chrome browser and it enters this particular URL. So that is the value coming from this particular browser-config properties. So we are done with the first step. The second step, we need to search the Selenium tutorial. So that one, how we can do is, we have already implemented page object model concept. So I'll go to this YouTube search page class. I'll create the object of this particular class and then I'll call to this particular method. So this performs the action in the search page. That is, after opening this particular web page, so it is going to perform the search action on this particular page. So I'm going to create the object of this particular class in the step 2. So this particular class, it takes the one argument, that is a driver type. Then I'm going to call one method called, let me import the related packages, because we are creating a object of that particular class that is existing in the different packages. So here I'm calling to one method called navigate to result page. So this particular method is implemented in the YouTube search page. If you look at here, we have already implemented in the page classes. So that's it. So we are done with. So let me remove this. So that's all. We are done with two steps. First, we are opened the Chrome browser and we have entered the URL by using this particular open browser utility. The second step, we are searching the Selenium tutorial by using this particular class we have already implemented in the pages, page classes, that is one method. By using this particular method, we are going to perform the search action on the youtube.com. Third action is, we need to click on the channel name. So that we have already implemented in the YouTube result page. I'll go to this particular page, maximize it, and need to call this particular method. So I need to create the object of this particular class. So I'm opening the step definition file. So in the same way, we'll create the object of. So that's it. Just import the related packages. In this particular class, we have implemented one method that goes to the YouTube channel name. So navigate to channel name. Sorry guys. So it is clicking on the channel name. So then in the last step, we need to validate the particular channel name, which is going to display on the this particular tab. If you look at here, it is displaying the title of this web page is Selenium Java tutorials-backup and YouTube. So that is our expected values. So that's the reason here I'm going to define two values. We are going to assert the values, that is expected value and the actual value. So here I'm defining string expected channel name. So that's it. So here I'm going to copy this particular channel name, then hyphen YouTube. So this is the title we have in this particular page. If you look, if you mouse over on that particular tab, you are seeing Selenium Java TestEngine tutorials backup by YouTube. So that is our expected value. It should be the particular expected value. I'm specifying it. So I'll create one more string, that is actual value. Actual channel name. So that's it. So for this, how do I get the actual channel name? So that purpose, we have already implemented one method in the YouTube channel name page. So I'll create the object of this particular page. So I'll call to this particular get title. So this returns me the particular page title of that particular page tab. So what I'll do is I'm going to create the object. So for creating the object, I need to pass the driver object, then I need to import the related packages. So here I'm going to call get title. If you look at here, it is giving you that particular method and it is returning the string type of value. That is the reason I'm specifying the return type of value is actual channel name. So select this particular method. That's it. So we have expected channel name and the actual channel name. By using the assertion, we need to compare those channel names. What I will do is I'll use the assert dot assert equals. So first one is the actual value and the second one is the expected value. So first I'll take this particular actual value and I'll specify it here. And I'll take the expected channel name and I'll paste it here. So this particular assert equals, it is a method overloading concept. They have implemented it. So you can specify one more argument. Whenever these two are not matching, so this particular error message will be, this particular description will be printed on the console or in the reports. So I'll specify channel names are not matching. So this particular message will be printed only when this expected and the actual channel names are not matching. If it is matching, it is particular description will be not printing anywhere in the console or the reports. So that's all, guys. Let me execute this particular suit file. So it is going to launch the Chrome browser. It is searching with the values by Selenium by Backup.py and it is going to click on the channel name. Just clicked on the channel name, then it should get the title of this web page.
Hi, this is Backup.py Chincholikar.
So let me minimize it. Let us go to the result. So if you go to the console, channel names are not matching expected. So here if you look at this, it is saying channel names are not matching, but we are expecting Selenium Java TestEngine tutorials by Backup.py and YouTube. But here we are getting the title of that particular web page as this. So what we need to do is, In the result page, after clicking on the channel name, we should wait for some time so that we can get this particular name of this channel name. So what I'll do is I'll specify the sum weight in the after clicking on the channel name, that is in the result page. So what I will do is I'll copy this particular thread.sleep. After clicking on this particular link text, so let me modify this particular web element name, that is a channel name link. So that's it. I'll copy this particular channel name link, paste it. So after clicking on this channel name in the result page, it is going to wait for 2 seconds, then it is going to get the title of that particular web page. So let me execute one more time. Before that, we'll go to the stub definition file and we will close the browser here, because we have not closed browser anywhere. By using the quit, I'm going to close the particular browser. So that's it. I will run this particular testng.xml file. Hey, sorry guys, if you are hearing background noise. So it is in the result page, now it is in the channel page.
Hey, hi everyone, this is Bakkappa Chincholikar. Welcome back to Test Automation Tools Selenium.
So I think it has not closed the web browser. Let's go to the script. So it is got failed. So still it is saying. So almost we are getting the channel names are same, but because of the spaces, it is quite different. I'll copy this particular text box. I mean the text. So this is our actual text. So because of the spaces, it is not matching it exactly. So I'll go to the validation stub definition file. In the expected also I'll mention the same. Because of the spaces, it is not going to match it properly. So if you look at here, perfectly it is printing that particular description what we have provided in the assertion statement. Channel names are not matching. So this particular assertion error will be displayed, I mean the description will be displayed only when assertion got failed. Now if I execute this particular testng XML file, it should be running properly without displaying any error message. So it has launched the Chrome browser and it has entered the URL and it is searching for the Selenium by Bakkappa and it has clicked on the channel. Now it has closed the web browser, and if you look at the result, there are 0 failures and 0 skips. So if you look at the scenario and all the steps what we have mentioned, all are passed. So that's it. If we go to this particular target folder, let me refresh target folder. If I open index.html file, here you can see the tag name what we have used, and this is our future name, YouTube channel's name validation. Under the validation, all the steps what we have created all the exist in this particular HTML report. If you got error, this all the error description will be printed over in the HTML format of reports. So that's all guys in the part of developing hybrid automation framework. And if you have any questions, and you can drop me any email to my Gmail ID. So next tutorial on Cucumber BDD, data-driven framework development. So please click on subscribe button If you want to get more updates from this particular channel, please like and share this particular video. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this Selenium Cucumber BDD framework tutorial. Hey, hi guys, this is Bakkappa Chincholikar. In this session, we'll discuss how to develop a data-driven automation framework, which is a combination of Cucumber BDD framework, page object model, Selenium Mind, TestNG. So let us jump to the high-level agenda. First, we'll discuss what is data-driven testing. Then we'll discuss what is scenario outline. Then we'll discuss examples keyword. Then we'll see the simple design of feature file once we develop a data-driven testing feature file. Then we'll discuss a sample automation scenario which we'll be using for the automation purpose. Then we'll see a sample demo on how to perform data-driven testing on the any given scenario. So data-driven testing is nothing but, say for example, you consider a simple login page where the user enters the username and password, and whenever he enters the username and password as a valid one, he should be able to log in into the system. So the second type of scenario is, that is a positive scenario, and the negative scenario is sometimes user may enter invalid credentials, that is he may enter the invalid password and invalid username. So in sometimes he may enter the combination of numeric values and special characters. So in this case, the test case is same, but the data which you are passing is different. So in this case, you need to perform the data-driven testing instead of writing multiple test cases for each of the test data. So scenarios outline is nothing but whenever you are representing a feature file for the data-driven testing, so you need to represent it as a scenario outline. So in case of sample scenario, you'll be writing it as a scenarios, but whenever you are performing data-driven testing, you need to represent scenario as a scenario outline. Examples keywords is nothing but, examples is the one keyword, so that we'll be using to provide the test data to the feature file. So let us move on to the next slide, where I have shown the design of the sample feature file. So this is my sample feature file. Whenever I design a simple feature file that contains a data-driven testing, so when first you need to represent scenario as a scenario outline. So in case of normal scenarios, you'll be representing only scenario, but whenever you are performing data-driven testing, you need to represent scenario as the scenario outline. And the second step, what I have done is, here I have specified in the angular brackets and within the string. So I have specified the search string. So this is the name. I will get it from the examples table. So if you look at here, this is a search string. So this is a particular name, that is the header name, you can say, for this particular test data. So that name you need to provide in the steps wherever you are passing this particular test data. So in my case, I have passed only two types of test data. So if you look at this particular scenario, just I have opened the Chrome browser and I have entered the URL. So here I'm searching for the Selenium tutorial or channel name, then I'm clicking on the channel name, then I'm validating the channel name in the channel name page. So after that, I have specified the examples keywords. This is a header name for this particular table. So every time this particular scenario got executed, so it will pass first set of test data, that is the Selenium by Bakkappa N. So first it will pass this particular test data and it will run this particular scenario. And after that, in the second time, it will pass this particular test data and it will run this particular scenario. So in this case, scenario remains the same, but whatever the test data you are passing is totally different. So here I'm passing for this particular step when search Selenium tutorials or channel name. In this case, I'm passing the this particular test data. So let us move on to the Chrome browser. So first we'll discuss the scenario, then with respect to that we'll be writing our automation script. So first I will open the youtube.com, then I will search for something here. I'm searching for selenium by Buckapayan. So after that I will click on this particular channel name. In this case I am just writing the title of this particular tab. So if I hold my mouse on the title of this particular tab, so it is showing the Selenium Java Test Engine Tutorials -Buckapayan-YouTube. So that is one we are validating here. So if I go back, in this particular scenario, this particular data I will be passing it as a different one. First I will be passing it as a Selenium by Buckapayan. Next time I'll pass it as a different parameter. So if I go to the Eclipse IDE, so we have already created three pages. So that is a YouTube search page, in the com.testautomation.pageobjects. In this particular package, I have created three pages. In the previous Cucumber BDD tutorials with the page object model. So first I have created a YouTube search page, then I have created YouTube result page, then I have created YouTube channel page. So let us quickly create one simple feature file. So what I will do is, so I'll copy this particular scenario. So what we have created in the previous tutorial. So I'm renaming this particular feature file name as data driven testing. So that's it. Click on finish. Sorry, OK button. If I open this particular, let me close other files. So let us quickly represent this particular scenario as a scenario outline. So that's it. So in the first step, I'm just opening the Chrome browser with URL, and after that I'm searching for the Selenium tutorial. Then I'm clicking on the channel name and I'm validating the channel name. So that's what we have discussed in the Selenium in previous tutorial, that is Cucumber BDD framework with the page object model. So first we have represented scenario with the scenario outline. Let me rename this particular, represent this feature as a data driven testing. So that's it. So we are done with specifying the scenario outline for this particular scenario. So next part is we need to specify the examples keyword. That is where we will get the test data examples. Colon. So this is the header name. That is, we need to specify it as a, I'll specify it as a search string. So that's it. This is a header name I need to pass into the step. So I'll copy this particular string. I'll paste it in the search Selenium tutorials. So that should be in angular brackets surrounded with the double quotes. So that's it. It is very simple. Still this particular step is not implemented, so we'll discuss how to implement that particular step. So here I need to pass the different sets of test data. First I will say Selenium by Buckapayan. That's it. Next set of test data, I'm passing it as a Selenium by Selenium WebDriver by Selenium WebDriver by Buckapion. So that's it. So we have represented this particular feature file as a annotation data driven testing, and followed by we have specified the scenario as a scenario outline. Then after that we have created one simple examples keyword and we have specified the header, then followed by the test data. First it will run this particular scenario with this particular test data. It will pass Selenium by Buckapion to the YouTube search in the search page, and it will perform the next steps. And after that it will pass this particular test data, that is Selenium WebDriver by Buckapion, and it will run whole this particular scenario. So let me go to this particular step, and we need to add as a parameter in the step definition file. So let me go to this in the step def package, that is com.testautomation.stepdef. Under this we have implemented all the step definition for this particular feature in the previous tutorial. So I will go to this particular step def class. Let me open this, maximize this. So in the first step what we have done is we have open Chrome browser with URL. So these properties we are getting it from the browser name and the from the resources, that is browser name and the base URL. So after that we are navigating into the result page. So we are searching for the Selenium tutorials. So this is where we need to update. So if I go to this particular feature file, search Selenium tutorial by, here I'm passing as a parameter, right? So after these keywords we need to specify the symbols so it can consider it as a parameter. So what I will do is, after tutorials you need to write dot star within the brackets so after that we need to specify one backward slash and double quotes, followed by you need to specify one more backward slash and the double quotes. This is how you represent any of the parameters. So this will consider it as a parameter, so that is coming from the feature file. So once we have a test data for this particular step, so we need to take into this particular step, right? So in this step, so that's why I'll pass this particular test data to the this particular method. So I'll specify the string as a parameter. So we are getting the string value, right, in this particular step in the when. So if you look at here in the when, we are getting the string value. First time we are getting Selenium by Buckapion. Next time we are getting Selenium WebDriver by Buckapion. So I'll go to this particular step definition file. So I'll specify the argument. So whenever we got the test data in this particular step, put into this particular argument. So what I will say here is search string. That's it. So every time test data receives to this particular step, it will store into this particular parameter. So what I will do is, I need to use this particular parameter. So if I go to this particular method, in this particular method we are passing it as a by using the send keys method. So what I will do is, I'll parameterize this particular method with the string search string. So that's it. So I will delete this from the page object model. just simply I will specify this particular string, particular parameter. So whenever I am calling to this particular method, so whatever I am passing from this particular parameter, so that data will be passing into this particular method and it will be sending to this particular search text box and it will click on the next button, search button. So what I will do is I'll copy this and I'll pass to the this particular navigate to result page method. So what in a simple way I can say it is we have a one page object model class. Within this class we have implemented one abstraction method. So abstraction method, we have just parameterized it. So whenever I'm calling to this particular method, I need to pass the test data to this particular navigate to result page. In that way, I'm calling that particular method in the step definition class. It's very simple. So that's all. Let me go to the this particular data driven feature file. That's it, guys. So what I will do is I will run this particular feature file. So I'll take this particular representation of this particular feature file and I'll go to the test runner. And I'll specify it here. Let me maximize it. So that's it. So I'll go to the test runner file, testng file, and I'll run this particular. Before running, I will update this particular project. Maven 9 update project. Wait for a minute, guys, because it is not responding. So that's it. So I will run this particular testng.xml file. So it has launched the Chrome browser. So it has stopped after opening the URL. So it is not entering the particular test data what we have provided. So let me maximize this results. So it is saying you can implement the missing steps in the snippet below. So what I will do is I will copy this particular representation. So I think we need a little changes in this particular naming convention is required. So I will copy this particular step name and I'll go to the step definition file, that is YouTube channel validation.java. So I'll replace with the latest one. That's it. If I go to the data driven dot sorry, data driven testing dot feature file. So it should be fine now. So now it is navigating into the particular feature file. So let me run now. Run as test as suit. So now it has opened the Chrome browser and it has to enter the first set of test data, and the next time it has to enter the second set of test data, and it should go to the respective channel and it has to validate the title of the tab in the respective pages. So now it has searched with the Selenium by Buckapion. Then it has navigated to the respective channel. First test is completed. The second test is running now. So it should enter the Selenium WebDriver by Buckapion now. So because the scenario is same, the data what we are passing here is a different one. If you look at here, it has passed the Selenium WebDriver by Buckapion. So simply it is validating the title of the tab in the respective pages. So if you look at here, two scenarios, that is two are passed and total test run is only one. There are zero failures and there are zero skips. So that's all guys for the data driven testing. If you have any questions, you can email to my email ID. So next tutorial on data tables in Cucumber BDD framework with Selenium WebDriver. Please click on subscribe button if you want to get more updates from this particular channel. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Hey, hi guys, this is Bakappa Chincholikar. Today I'm giving session on how to read a particular test case test data, or how to treat a particular Excel file as a database. So let me give you a scenario how exactly we are reading the particular test case test data. So this is a sample Excel file I have created here. So first I have given all the header like name, test case ID, run. So based on this particular row, if it is mentioned it as a yes, then that particular test case test data will be picking up and that particular test case will be getting executed. So here I have mentioned name, test case ID, run, skill 1, skill 2. These are the simply some fields I have mentioned. So based on that, these are the keys. So based on these keys, this particular test data will be fetching in your test case and you are putting into the web application and you are performing all the validations. So in the main intention of this tutorial is how to fetch a particular test case test data, or how to treat a particular Excel file as a test, I mean the database. So based on the query, we are getting the test data for the particular test case. So first I will go through with that code, and after that we will demonstrate how to implement this particular concept in your framework. It doesn't matter whether it is a Selenium framework or Selenium Cucumber BDD framework. This concept is very important to run any test cases. To run any test cases, we need a test data. So I think this is a very good approach we need to use in most of the framework. So first what I will do is I will go through with the code, then quickly we will go to the Eclipse IDE and we will implement this particular logic. So first I will go to this particular text file so I can explain you how we need to implement this particular logic. So we need to use a fillo. This is the jar file. You can get this particular dependency from the Google also. So you can just search by Maven dependency for fillo. So this particular dependency, I'm using it to fetch the particular test case test data from the Excel file. So first I will explain you the what exactly this particular code is doing. It is a very single method. So it is accepting the test data file parameter, then sheet name. This is a test data file path where exactly your test data file exists, and after that within that particular file what is the sheet name. Then another parameter it is accepting, that is test case ID. So this test case ID we need to specify it from the this particular Excel file. Whatever the test case ID you are mentioning here, based on that this particular method is going to retrieve the test data. So first what I have done is, first I have created the object of tree map. So basically map will be used whenever you are storing the data in the format of key and value pairs. So tree map basically it sorts the values in the based on the keys. So here I have created the object of tree map, then after that I have stored that into the map type. So basically map is the interface where the tree map is implementing all the methods from the map. So after that I have created one simple variable called query. So I have assigned null to this particular query variable. In the next line what I have done is, I have written simple query. So this is a database query. Based on this query I will be getting the test data for the particular test case. So in this case so here I have mentioned the percentages. So this is nothing but I am getting the runtime value. Say for example here I am saying select star from, this is a runtime value, that is the first parameter, that is sheet name, from which sheet I need to get the value, I mean the test data file. And after that where run is equal to yes, so based on the whenever the first it is focusing on that this particular sheet name, then it is focusing on the yes row. And the one more condition we have is test case ID. So based on this test case, if yes and this particular test case matches, then it is going to return you the this particular row test data into the in your script. So that's it. So here I'm passing test sheet name and the test case ID. So this is my query. So based on this particular query you will be getting the test data for the each of the test cases. So that's it. So here I'm creating the object of fillo. So basically this particular jar file is going to provide us the functionality of, like it provides the bridge between our script and the Excel file. So it retrieves the test data based on the query. In the next line I have created the connection reference variable. So basically this connection reference variable, it is used to create the connection to the Excel file, that is a test data file. So after that we have record set reference variable. It is basically it stores the all the values whenever after executing the query. So first we have discussed, like we have created the tree map object, after that we have defined the query, and after that we have created the object of fillo and connection reference variable and record set reference variable. By using those stuffs, now we need to write the main logic. So in the try what I am doing is, here I am trying to create the connection to the Excel file. So this particular Excel test data file path, I'm getting it from this parameter. Whenever I call to this particular method, so I'll be passing the test data file path. So that to that particular Excel, we are creating the connection by using the get connection method. And after that, by using the execute query, I'm going to execute this particular query, what we have written in this line. Then it is returning you the set of results. So by using the while, if I have next value in the record set, just it is entering into this particular while loop. The main logic is here only. So whenever we are by using the record set dot get field names, so this particular get field names, what it does, this particular method, it is returning you the all the column names, that is the header column names, name, test case ID, run, skill 1, skill 2, etc., etc., till skill 10. So all these header names will be retrieved by this particular get field names. Then after that, I have put that into the for loop. So every time, whenever the each first value I get from this particular row, first I'll get the name value, then it is assigned to the this field. Then under this particular for loop, what I'm doing is I'm taking the name, this is a name column, then I'm assigning the this particular backup end to the this particular first column name, that is name. So basically how it stores is, this put is a method where you are putting the test data into the map, that is a key and value format. So we have similar way, we have get method. Based on the key value, it is going to retrieve the data from the map. So in the first case, what happens? So here field is nothing but name, and the here this particular record set dot get field name of field, so it returns you the backup plan. So basically it stores the key and value format as key is equal to name and the value is equal to backup plan. In the similar way, so this we have get field names, right? So it is returning you the all the column names like test case ID, run, skill 1, skill 2, skill 3, skill 4, like that. So in case of still, it runs till skill 10. So in the at last, it will key value will be skill 10 and the value will be, sorry, key will be skill 10 and the value will be n unit framework. So the in that way, this particular put method will put the test data that is in the format of key and value format. So in this try block, we have created the connection to the Excel file and we have executed the query. Based on the query, we have got result. Based on the result, we are putting the test data in the format of key and value format. If anything is error occurred in this particular try block, so catched by the this catch statement, and simply it will print through the, it will throw you the error, whatever the error information, exception information, then it will print you the this particular message, test data cannot find, like that. So at last, I'm closing the connection to that particular Excel file. Then I'm returning you the test data in map. So basically, so this is a reference variable. We are putting all the test data into this particular test data in map variable. So this particular test data in map is a type of variable is map type. So this particular map type, it always stores the data in the format of key and value format. So that's all, guys. Let us move on to the Eclipse IDE. I will show you the demonstration how exactly this particular code is going to work. So first I will take this particular dependency and I'll move to the Eclipse IDE. I'll open this particular pom.xml file. Then I will go down. Simply I will paste this particular dependency. So that's it. And after that, what I will do is, under this particular com.testautomation.utility, I am going to create one class called Excel Handler. So that's it. I will click on finish button. So simply I will copy and paste that particular method what we have discussed till now. So that's all. So we need to import couple of packages. So let me import those type of packages. So this particular map is coming from the java.util. So basically this particular method is return type is map type. So that's the reason we have written the map type of object. So let us import this fillo. So already we have got this option because we have added the that particular fillo dependency in the pom.xml, right? So if you have not added, you will not get this particular option. So import those stuffs, and also you need to import the connection from the fillo. In the same way, import the record set that should come from the fillo only. So make sure that you are importing it from the fillo jar file. In the same way, you have to import this tree map coming from the java.util. So we have simple classes ready. Simple class is ready with one method, that is a get test data in map. So we need to pass three parameters whenever we are calling this particular method. First is test data file and the sheet name and the test case ID. So that's it. So let us quickly create one simple future file. What I will do is simply I will copy this particular data driven testing dot future and I'll paste into the future file. I'll rename this particular future file into the test data reading. So that's it. So let me open this particular file. So what I will do is I will delete all these stuffs. I don't want it. So I'll delete this scenario outline also. So I will keep it only. I'll rename this particular annotation with test data reading. Then I will rename this future with the test data reading for the test cases. So in the same way, I'll copy this future description to the scenario description. So here I'll in the given I will write read test data for test case. So let me go to this particular Excel. So I wanted to read the test data for this particular test case, that is test case 001. So here I'll mention test case underscore 001. So that's it. So what I will do is I'll take this particular annotation. I will go to the runner. I'll open this runner file. I'll maximize this, and here I'll just replace with the my future file where exactly my scenario is exists. So that's all. So now what I will do is I need to place the my test data file into the framework, right? So that's the reason I will create here one simple folder. So here I'm specifying resources resources underscore test data. So that's it. I will click on finish button. So under this resources and hyphen test data, so under this I will copy this particular test data file what we have I have created before. So I will paste under the resources hyphen test data. So that's it. So if I open this particular Excel file, just a second guys, yes, it's opened. So this is a test data file I have. So first what I will do is I need to mention where exactly this particular Excel file is, what is the sheet name. So we have sheet name as test data 01 and where exactly this particular test data file and the test case name I need to mention. So we have test case I underscore 001 is the test case name here, I mean the test case ID. So what I will do is I need to create the step definition file for this particular scenario file, right? So what I will do is we have mentioned the test runner, that is the annotation what we have used to represent this particular scenario in this test runner. So let us execute this testng.xml file. So once I execute that particular file, so I will get the definition for this. So I'll copy this definition and I will go to the com.testautomation.stepdef. Under this I will create the one simple class. So here I'm giving the class name as test data reading step def after that. So that's it. I will click on finish button. So under this I will implement the that particular step what we have created the future file. So you need to import the given class into the current class. So that's it. So we have already implemented this particular method in the Excel handler class. So what I will do is I will use this particular class as it is the static class. So I can call directly by using the class name. So here I'm calling Excel handler dot. So here you are able to see the that particular method name what we have implemented just now. So that is get test data in map. So first you need to specify the test data file where exactly and what is the sheet name and what is the test case ID. So first I need to get the test data file path. So where exactly we have kept our test data file. So as you know, we have created the one folder that is resources underscore sorry hyphen test data. So in this test data sheet we have the our test data for the test cases. I'll go to the properties and I need to get the path of this particular file. So I will copy from this particular so here I'm copying it from the resources hyphen test data then followed by the Excel file name. So I'll come here. So you have to specify under the string. So it should be forward slash. So that's it. So we need to mention the sheet name. So we have sheet name as test data 01. So I'll copy this. You have to pass in the format of string. Then we need to pass the test case ID. So I'll copy the test case ID here. I want to read this particular row test data, I mean the test case 1 test data. So I'll copy this particular test case ID. Then I will paste it. So as you know, this particular method is going to return the map type of object here. So I need to store this particular value into the map type. So what I will do is just I will copy this and I will go to this particular class. Then I will assign it to the this particular map type. So this particular test map in data variable will be storing all the this particular test data for this test case 1. So first pair will be name will be key, and this particular backup ion will be the value, and the second time it will store the test case ID and test case 1 as the value. So always it stores the value in the format of key and value. So that's it. So here I wanted to read the value of, say for example, if I wanted to read this particular qmatrix value, I need to use this as a key. So what I will do is I will use the map object. So just I wanted to print on the screen whatever the value. So here I wanted to print the qmatrix framework as the value. So I need to use the skill 7 as the key here. So I wanted to print on the screen. So I will use the system.out.println. So you need to use this particular reference variable. So as I said before, we use the put method to put the data into the map. So here I'm using the get method. So you need to specify the key value. So it returns the value based on the key. So here I need to specify the key value. So if I wanted to read the qmatrix framework, I need to specify this particular key in the under the get method. So that's it. So this particular system.out.println is going to print the value of skill 7 as the, sorry, this particular key contains this particular value. So here it is going to print the qmatrix framework as the value on the screen. So if I save everything, so let me close all the stuffs here. Then I will simply run the test ng. Let me close the Excel sheet. So I will run this particular testng.xml file, run as testng suit. So if you look at the output here, so it is returning me the qmatrix framework. Say for example, if you want to read the different test data, so like this you can, let me go to the definition here. So here I have specified skill 7. So based on the test case, it is based on the test case, this particular test case, I'm getting the test data. So here we have n number of values like this, skill 1, skill 2, skill 3. So like this values you will be getting in the test cases based on the key. So you can utilize and you can enter in the based on the need in the web application, and you can perform your validations. So let me, if say for example, if I wanted to read the, so this is the first test case. Say for example, if I have implemented n number of scenarios, if you want to read the nth test case test data. So say for example, if I wanted to read test case 7 test data, so based on the skill 7, so just I will change this particular test case and I'll specify this particular key. So in this case, just I will give the different test case ID here. So it is going to print the. So now it was printing us the Qmetric framework based on that this particular test case. So if I wanted to read the test case 7 test data, what I need to do, just I need to specify this particular test case ID. So if I execute, so if I execute this testengine.xml file, so it is going to print as the value of Selenium Java testng cucumber. That particular value should be printed on the screen. So let us open it. So if you look at here, it is printing you the that particular value. So based on the test case, you can print on the screen. So like that, you can specify n number of keys and you can print the n number of values based on the need. And later you can perform all the validations by using the assertions and all. So at last, I have one assignment for you people. So what you need to do is under resources, create one properties file, specify all the this particular where test data file path and the sheet name. This can be like manually entered one based on the scenario, based on the test cases, you can get the test data. But you can create one simple properties file under this resources, specify the sheet name and the Excel path and read the particular test case test data. So that's all I have in this session. If you have any questions, please comment in the comment section. You can try at your end, and if you find any difficulties in doing it, you can reach out to me and you can comment in the comment section. And stay tuned for next tutorial on how to take this particular test data into the next step. Say for example, if I open this particular data-driven testing, so we are just I'm giving the example, we are reading the test data in this particular step. So next thing is I wanted to enter the test data in this particular step. So how I can do that particular, how I can write a particular logic for that. So we can discuss that particular logic in the next tutorial. If you like this particular tutorial, please click on like and share button. And if you want to learn more on Selenium, Cucumber BDD, any automation testing, please click on subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial on test data reading. Hey, hi guys, this is Bakkappa Chincholikar. In the previous tutorial, we have discussed how to read this particular test data, based on the S row, by writing a simple method. We have discussed how to write this particular test data based on the key, and the by using the key we are reading the this particular value. So in this tutorial we'll discuss how to take your test data into the n number of steps. Say for example, if you have a future file having n number of steps, so how to carry forward your test data into the in multiple steps. So in most of the times you may need to carry your test data into the multiple steps. So we'll discuss how to take your test data into the multiple steps. So here I'm defining two more steps by using the when keyword. Read test data for So here I'm just mentioning read test data for skill 2, and then in the same way I will write then keyword, and just I will copy this and I'll paste it here. So here I'll mention just 3. So in the second step, we will be reading the test data for this particular skill 2 value. In the third step, we are reading the value of skill 3, that is Java. So we need to implement these two methods. Sorry guys. So we need to implement these two methods in the step definition file. So let us open the step definition file. So before opening the step definition file, just I will run this particular testng.xml file. So you got two step definition file implementation. That is what you need to implement here, because it is not implemented yet. So I will go to this particular step definition file, sorry, package, that is com.testautomation.stepdef. I will open this particular class. So I'll just maximize this. So here just I will implement those two steps in this particular class. So that's it. So just import the when from the cucumber.api. Then in the same way, just import the then keyword. So that's it. So next step is we will create a sample class file, so that handles our test data. So under com.testautomation.utility, I will create one class called test data handler. So that's it. I will click on finish button. So in this particular class, what I will do is just I will create a simple hash map object, new hash map. So this particular hash map contains key and value pairs, right? So first string is nothing but key, and the next string is nothing but the value which holds. Then I will simply assign to the map type. So map is a super interface for the hash map. In the same way, I will mention the key and value of type string. So then I will mention the reference variable. So here I'm mentioning test data in map. So that's it. So by just I will import the related packages for map and the hash map, that is from the util package. So both hash map and map, that comes from the java.util package. So that's it. So by using this particular reference variable, what I will do is I will generate setters and getters for this particular variable. So I will select this particular reference variable and I will right click on that particular variable, go to the source, then here you select the generate getters and setters. So simply it will ask you, like, these are the particulars, get test data in map and set test data map, like what are the method names. It will just gives you the information here. Just you say click on OK. So that's it. So as we have, this is a public class and we have a public method. So whenever we are accessing these two methods, we need to create the object of this particular class. So what I will do is I will create the object of this particular class in the step definition file. So here I will create the object of this test data handler class. So here I'm just using the new operator and creating the object of that particular class. So that's it. So just you need to import the related packages, because as it is exist in the different package. So that's it. So in the previous tutorial, I have given you the one assignment. In this particular step, we are reading test data from the Excel file, right, based on the S row. So I had given you the one assignment. So here we had passed the test data file path, that is this particular test data path we have entered manually. So I asked you to just create a one sample properties file like this and mention your test data file path and the sheet name in this particular properties file, and you read this particular properties file and get the values in the this particular step. So I had implemented and it is working fine for me. So I had just created the object of this particular class, and after that just I have used the get property method. Then by using this properties, I'm able to read the test data file and the sheet name. So these two keys are exist under the this particular properties file. So that is test data file path and the sheet name. So by using these two keys, I'm able to access test data file path and the sheet name. So after that, I have passed the test case name. Based on that, it returns me the test data. So if I run this particular testng.xml file, so it will returns you the sum value that is there in the we are getting the Qumetry framework. So as we are reading the test data for test case 1, so in this particular test case, in the test case 1, we are reading the skill 7 as a key, and this is the value we are getting. So what I will do is, in this particular step, so by using the object of this particular test data handler, I am going to call the one method called set. So as we have a get method and a set method for in that particular class, so I'm going to set the value of type map type. So I will set the this particular test data. After reading the test data based on the S row, I'm getting the test data in the format of hash map. So I'm putting this particular test data into the, I'm setting that particular test data into the this particular method, so that I can get that particular test data in map in the later steps. So that is in this particular two step and the third step. So what I will do is, in the next step, by using the reference variable of this, I'm going to call the get test data in map. So this particular method, it is going to return me the type of value is map type. So I need to store this particular value in map type, and then I can access based on the key. I can access that particular value, whatever there in the S row. So that's it. I will store this into the map type, map. So this is our key and the value. And after that, I will mention the reference variable name. So that's it. So in the same way, just I will print the value on the screen in the similar way how we are printing the Qumetry framework, that is a skill 7 value. In the same way, I will print the So here we are reading the test data for skill 2. So I will just copy the skill 2 key so that I can read this particular Selenium app driver. So I will just copy here and I'll paste it here. So you need to just change this particular map name. So that's it. So I have used this particular key reference variable. After that, I'm using the get method to get this particular key value. So whatever there in the Excel. In the same way, I will copy this and I will paste it here. So in this third step, what we are doing is we are trying to read the skill 3 value. So here I need to just change the skill 3. So I need to specify this particular key so that I can read Java. So that's it, guys. So what we have done, we have created simple test handler class. So in this particular test handler class, we have created simple variable hash map type. Then by using this reference variable, we have generated setters and getters. These get test data in map and set test data map in, these methods are called here. So basically in the first step, we are setting the test data. In the future steps, just we are getting the test data by using the get test data in map. So that this particular method is going to return us the data in the format of map, that is key and value format. In the same way, it is used in the third step as well. So here the output expected is, first it will print the skill 7, that is skill 7 QMATRI framework. Then it will print you the skill 2 value, that is Selenium WebDriver. And the third value it is going to print is skill 3 value, that is Java. So let us run this particular testng.xml file. If you look at here, so first it is going to return us the value of QMATRI framework, then it is returning us the Selenium WebDriver. The third value we are getting it as a null. Let us check it why it is returning us the null value. Go to the step definition file. So why it is returning us the null value? If you check this particular get method, we have specified the Java. So you need to specify the proper key name. So we need to specify the skill 3 as the key, and so that it can return the respective value in the map. So it is not able to find the key as Java, so that's the reason it is returning as the null value. So let us execute this once again testng.xml file. If you look at here, so first it is printing you the QMATRI framework, then second it is printing you the Selenium WebDriver, then third it is printing you the Java. Okay guys, that's all I have in this session. If you like this video, please click on like button and share button. And if you want to get updates from this channel, click on subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial on test data reading.